The Nano didn't just generate excitement for consumers. It got car makers thinking seriously about value engineering and design and the cost advantages of a low-margin car. Renault, Nissan, Bajaj followed suit, as did almost every other car maker in the country, in the pursuit of a mini car that was cheap. So why, when expensive mid-segment cars and SUVs have margins and profit levels that are four times greater? Maruti's business model is a great answer. Despite all its variety of models, the 800 was the volume driver for a number of years, a required car for any player. That's why at least six new small cars will hit the roads next year. Take General Motors India, for example, who just previewed its small car, the Beat. Executives say it's all about customer value.
The Beat is our second product to come to the market in the most recent past. So obviously we see them as a pair, but in different areas of our business. This is in the all-important mini segment, so it'll add to our Spark and our Yuva. Gives us a third offering in the same segment. Different place for this. This is an all-new global product from Chevrolet. So I think you'll see that the styling here is futuristic, both interior and exterior, and the kind of offerings that you've got in the package of the Beat as well is really positioning this at the high end of the mini segment.
But small doesn't always mean cheap. As the small car portfolio for consumers expands to include a variety of choices, the hatchback emerges as a diminutive but expensive choice for discerning buyers. At times, it's also a luxury item. Take the Volkswagen Beetle that was launched recently. Priced at almost 22 lakh rupees, it's almost the same price as a BMW in some countries. And for some, small cars can also mean small volumes.
This is a new market for me, where possibly I have no competition. So I need to test the market and then decide what the numbers would be. I already have a confirmed order of 150 units, and I have got the inquiry of total 200 cars.
Still, the reality is that India's low penetration of car owners and high percentage of youth buyers for cars in the 3 to 5 lakh rupee range is the one that's growing in volumes. And that's the price point where auto players will take aim.
Even as we move into 2010, you can start to expect at least a dozen to perhaps more new models being launched in the small car space, and that of course includes hatchbacks. But the real point to take away is this: for auto players to be successful in the competitive landscape that is India's auto economy today, they have to have a small car that is practical, cheap and convenient for customers. Otherwise, making profits is going to be difficult. Pavan Lal, Bloomberg UTV, Mumbai.